Hi, everybody. My name is Alicia, and you're listening to Real Conversations with Sheeta and Nikki, and I am today's featured guest. Let's get into it.
Lunch breaks, outtakes, we know how to vibe. Interviews and twos, latest news. Read your comments too, what are you thinking? Ooh, have lunch with us too, conversations with you. Real conversations with Sheeta and Nikki. Real conversations with Sheeta and Nikki. Yeah. Real conversations with Sheeta.
Welcome to season 2, episode 2 of Real Conversations with
Sheeta
and Nikki. Our book series starts today with our special guest, Miss Alicia Mosley. Alicia is the owner of Natural Stimulus LLC and author of One Day. It takes one day to begin your health journey.
Yes. The book One Day, It Takes One Day to Begin Your Health Journey is a 31-day health journey. It takes you through 31 days of how to choose a healthy lifestyle. It begins with why you want to pursue and maintain a healthy lifestyle. Each day has a different focus and gives you a guide and focus on that specific day. One Day, It Takes One Day to Begin Your Journey book focuses on health from an individualistic view. So please help us welcome book author and business owner, Miss Alicia Mosley. Welcome to the show, Alicia.
Welcome. Thank you for having me. And I'm excited about the topics for the day, the real conversations as we talk about One Day in health.
Yes.
Yeah. So can you tell us a little bit, Alicia, about what really inspired you to write this book?
So what inspired me to write this book? I've always, like I said, always been into health, and health is something that I have a great passion for. And I work with multiple individuals who are on their health journey. And I will always just say it takes one day. And so I knew there was a book in me, but I just didn't know, like, okay, which way to go for help. So I always used to say to people, like, it takes one day. And I think we're always trying to figure out, how do I start health? Where do I begin? And so yeah. It's just like one day. If you just focus on today, then you focus on the next day. And I think if we just focus on each day at its one time, then the health journey will not become so taxing and so overconsuming. And so that's what inspired me to write the book, is to just teach people how to just focus on one purpose, one focus, and one day. And as you go through the book, you'll see each topic and how you only focus on that topic for the day.
Yeah. I think that's so, it's good to have a book like that, just because it can be overwhelming try to figure out how can you incorporate healthy eating and like a healthy, you know, lifestyle. So for the book to be called One Day, I feel like it gives people a sense of like ease to know that, okay, it doesn't have to be overwhelming. I can just take it one day or one step at a time.
Mm-hmm. Right. Definitely. And that's the thing I want to ask you a question about. Like myself, I can do so good for maybe, as I've gotten older, it didn't dwindle down for maybe a week to maybe 2 or 3 days now.
Okay.
Well, what advice would you give to somebody that said, oh, I've messed up, so just forget it. I ain't gonna even do it. How do you get back into that mindset of, okay, that's one day I messed up, let's get back on the bandwagon? How do you do that?
Well, even in the book, and if you get the book, the first day I start with is your why. So anytime you have a why, if your why is just, you know, I want to lose weight and you lost, you know, 1 pound, then you have technically accomplished your why, which is why I talk about specific. But that's why the focus is just one day. It's like, we can't keep putting ourselves, okay, I'm 2 days in, I messed up, I should just stop. No, okay, today was not a good day. How can I focus on doing better? So for me, I had this whole thing, I'm gonna do water, this and that. If I screwed up and didn't do it today, then I focus on the next day. What can I add? If mine is no dairy, but I ate dairy, okay, what can I add that's healthy? And just kind of making a choice each day of like, okay, what can I do to add some form of health? or if I messed up on my goal, just being more mindful of what to choose for that day. So if I ate fried food and junk food and I was like, I wasn't going to do that and I messed up, well, then the next day I'm going to focus on eating salad, maybe, or trying to incorporate that and not focusing on the mess up, but just focusing on the continued goal. And I think we get stuck there. Like, I have a gym membership, being honest, and it's, you know, the winter just came and going outside when it's snow on the ground is not fun. Yeah. But I'm not at the point of saying, well, I'm just never going to exercise. I just tell myself, okay, tomorrow's Monday. I'm going to try to go. If I do, I go. If I don't, but I'm going to at least try to incorporate some form of exercising and just focusing on what can you do in that now, opposed to what you messed up and challenging yourself just to keep going each day.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like that. Can you tell us like a little bit about the contents of the book? Is it like mindset? Does it go into like dietary things that you should be eating, exercise?
So it's really simple. It kind of, like we said, it starts one day. So we talked about like a whole month and how one day leads to a month, one month leads to a year, and one year leads to a lifetime. So it's just a little bit of background about me. One day I was fine and I just got sick real bad. And so I went to the doctor. They was like, yeah, you have GERD. And I'm like, GERD, what is that? Mm-hmm. And so that kind of started my focus of when I changed my diet. Mm-hmm. So I was like, okay, but... So I was doing no meat for a minute. Then I did no pork, no beef. And then eventually beef got hard. I'm like, man, I'm missing out on all the good stuff.
Yeah.
But then I started realizing the more I kept going into my health journey, okay, eliminate this, eliminate that. But I just didn't eliminate everything. So there are times when I do go back. So what I focus on is all of the things that you would go through in a month's journey. So yes, it has nutrition, but that's only one day because we're not talking about, so we'll talk about the why, then the five things you need to focus on. But then I have word, it's going to, if you look at it, it's called like day five would be consistency. So we'll talk about consistency. What does that look like as it relates to your journey? Setting goals. So it's just a topic for each day and you kind of go through that topic and whatever your journey is, but we start with why. So why do you want to begin health? Yours can be, I want to detox. I want to lose weight for the summer. Something I'm going to actually be starting next month, actually in April, is taking people through the one-day journey on their personal goals. So if you say in April, I want to lose weight, we're going to actually go through that one-month journey, whatever your health goal is, and take the book each day. Because sometimes it's really about accountability. I even talk about finding an accountability partner. Over the summer, I walked with someone because they were trying to get their exercise in and get their numbers down because they had dealt with diabetes. Mm-hmm. And we just walked. And sometimes she was more committed than me because, you know, being thin and a little, you know, toned, you'd be like, oh, I'm good. But that doesn't mean, that doesn't mean that you're healthy, you know. So, like I said, the big thing is it's a topic and the topics that you'll deal with each week or it'll help you understand how you can go on this journey and how it can not just be one day, but it goes into a lifetime. And so that, I mean, a lifestyle. And so that's what I am on, is not just one day I eat healthy and the next day I don't, but letting each day lead to a healthy lifestyle.
Yes. I love that.
Yeah.
Love that.
Yes. Yeah. So your book, it also focuses on a more like natural, holistic approach on getting healthy. Can you tell us a little bit more about why you chose a more natural, holistic approach versus, you know, taking, you know, medications, you know, to help with, you know, different symptoms?
Okay. So the book is more about the journey, but definitely in the journey, because I'm going to talk about nutrition, exercise, and all of those. Right. But with the business, natural stimulus is more holistic because my approach, and nothing against medicine, but just for example, when I hit the GERD situation, their focus was to, hey, take this medicine, and I didn't feel well. So after I was taking it for so long, I'm like, something is not right here. Something is, it's not really causing my symptoms to go away. So when I changed my diet and I began to add other natural aspects in, then I started realizing that there was a change. Because one thing is, the body is made to heal itself. If you cut your finger, you don't have to go put medicine necessarily on it. It's going to start healing itself unless you have, you know, blood clotting issues or something. So the body really knows what to do. It knows, which is why, like, when you fast, then the body goes to starvation mode. So the body knows what to do. And we're not supposed to necessarily give it so many foreign things. So which is why I want to focus on giving the body what it needs. Food is medicine, herbs are medicine, and that's what our ancestors, you know, they lived long because they were not putting all of this. Now, I'm not going to say I'm going to take a pill if I get cramps. Me and cramps don't work out together. But I will, you know, but I try to be better. Like, I've even noticed with that, that when I eat differently, that I don't have as many challenges at that time of the month because my body knows what it needs. Right. And so food and natural things is giving the body just what it's supposed to have, which is those vitamins, those nutrients. So something made in a lab is not necessarily pure and not natural. And that's the goal of natural stimulus is to equip your body and stimulate your natural responses because your body knows what it needs and what to do when it's sick.
Man, I know I'm trying to change my life now. It's hard though. It's hard.
It gets challenging some days because there were days when I'm like, I'm straight vegetarian, I'm straight pescatarian. And then, you know, you get bored with it. And shout out to, you know, the Tabitha Browns and all of them who've been doing it for a long time. But I, like I said, I just focus on what's best for me. And, you know, it's not even just about food. It's exercise, it's stress management, it's sleep. Like, I'm going to get my 8 hours of sleep. So it's so much more. I think we focus on it. You know, it's I even talk about that in the book, elimination versus limiting. Like sugar is, you know, I eliminate things. I used to be the sugar and the rice person. Now I'm the salt and pepper. And I know people, I can't. But if you just try, like water is my substance, my beverage of choice. I don't really drink a lot of juice. So the more your body gets trained, the easier it becomes. And it's really just like, I was coming in from out of town. I saw all the snacks. And I was like, I just want that because I see it. And you got to tell you have real talks with yourself. Like,
that's true.
You just want that because you see it. You know, you craving it because it look good. Do you really need that? You know, so, and that's, I think if you do it that way and stop being so hard, like strong, oh, I got to do it this way. It's just like everything you pick up, tell yourself, is this something that's aiding me or helping my goal? And if it's not, you know, hey, maybe eat one of the Twizzlers instead of the whole pack. Reward yourself when you do, when you go exercise and say, okay, now I'm gonna eat a Twizzler. Like, I'm not that person to say, oh, don't, can't, not have, because you'll fail. It's just about every day. Even in my group called Choosing Health. So today I woke up and I said, you had a weekend away, you know, come in and get your fruits and vegetables, and I didn't eat meat for breakfast. So some people are like, what, no meat? But I've gotten accustomed to just not even wanting it anymore.
Yeah, that was actually one of my goals, to not eat like pork or beef. And I went a long time without eating it. I mean, now I kind of eat it here and there, but I pick up more like turkey or more chicken versus just beef or pork, you know, or salmon. I try to see, or at least choose other options other than just beef. Because sometimes people just pick up pork or beef, you know, like that's the only option. But there's fish, you know, there's chicken, turkey. So I am more mindful of
it's about being mindful. I'm 8 years for pork and I think 2 years for beef. And sometimes I want to, you know, but then I'm like, do I really want to? Or even chicken sometimes, like, but again, it's not just about, like, you know, it's so many reasons. It's just, like I said, you got to know your why. And for mine, it's just to be, they're not doing things the same way they did when our ancestors was eating them. And just knowing, you know, I'm really focusing on cancer and the things that can cause it. And so just limiting, not saying you can't have it. I know there are people around me who eat it. I will just say, just limit it if that's something you have to have. If you can't we try to go cold turkey, and I think that's where we fail. Yeah. But like you just said, being mindful when I go to the grocery store, don't go on the beef and pork aisle. Focus on the fish, chicken, and turkey.
Yeah.
Not that it can be even more healthier, per se. I mean, they all... Today, you don't know what's healthier, so...
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Not putting so much pressure on yourself. Mm-hmm. You know, because like you said, that's when you fail. Like, you know, putting too much pressure on yourself.
That's true.
And you get overwhelmed to the point where you just like, well, I just can't do this.
Yeah.
Because dairy is one of those, you know. I'm not a milk drinker, but I like ice cream. So sometimes it gets a hold of me, and I'm like, you know, and I know with dairy, you know, all of the health challenges, but it's not so, I don't eat cheese. So I'm like, okay, if I decided to have some dairy today, have I seen it fall short? No, it's just be mindful of what you're doing and then do detox. Okay. I've eaten things I shouldn't eat. Mm-hmm. Let me detox my body.
Yeah. And I noticed on your website that you sell like different like detox and different vitamin supplements. So can you talk to us a little bit about that as well?
Yeah, so I do, like I said, your general vitamins. I also have what we call is a monthly box called. Okay. So what I do is I send this out. You get three. You can of your choice. You get three products. You can choose any of the nine. I believe I have, which is vitamin C, vitamin D, zinc. The main vitamins for your immune health, because that's my goal is gut health and immune health. If your gut health and your immune health is intact, then you pretty much can. Flow, do pretty well. And so I'm not selling everything, but just like I said, Z, zinc, vitamin B, which is important for energy, do have a detox. And I know everybody's really into the Irish mouse or sea mouse. Mm-hmm. So I have it in pure form, which is those 92 vitamins and minerals that your body needs. And it's just giving you that boost of everything. I call it fortified stimulus, because it fortifies your body and your cells and all of those things. So those are all on the website. You can get them individually, or I have those who subscribe and get them monthly, and I send them out a box, and you just choose which three you want. And I send those out. This is all homemade. So I sit there and literally.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh,
so,
wow.
I feel the capsules myself. So.
Nice. I didn't know that. Yeah, so
it's all and some of the stuff, you know, just doing research. I'm in school now for naturopathic health and herbal health. So just what I'm at through research and what things. So I have, like, I just had a box go out, and some people just mainly want to focus on their immune health. And that's the vitamin C, vitamin D, because those are things you should be taking daily, especially as we're in the pandemic and coming out of it. Your Z, your zinc, your Z, I'm putting them together. C, D, zinc, and B12 if you want that energy boost and that food absorption. So,
I need to see. She looked at me because I don't take the vitamins.
She don't.
I need something for some energy. I just be moping around.
The good thing is we're about to go into the summer, but vitamin D, if you're deficient, that can cause a lot of immune stuff, like when your colds and all of those come in. So the good thing is we're going into the spring where you're going to get your vitamin D, but still. Best thing is, if you're not eating right, at least do supplements. So you can at least give your body something. So that's the thing, at least to say, okay. And I am going to work on something where it's not all vitamins, because I know it's hard. So we are working on where we can provide something that's more of like a liquid base or a powder base or something. Because people do get overwhelmed with taking my husband. When I come to him with the 20 vitamins, he's like,
right. Yeah, that's true. That's good to know, too, that you're looking into doing like more, having more options for customers as well. Because sometimes, I know like my grandma, she has a hard time like swallowing pills, so she has to crush everything up.
Well, the good thing about mine is you can break them apart to add them to the smoothie.
So
that's the benefit. Because it's the capsule, it's the pill form. But you can break it apart, add in a smoothie, add in a drink, make it into a tea, however you need to.
Do you have any advice for anyone, people that have like issues with gut health or like a health unhealthy gut? Is it any like certain supplements they should be taking?
Well, definitely you want to do the detox, which has your blessed thistle, your rutabaga root. So these are things that want to clean the colon and things. But the best thing, because we want to always do herbs, is go on a water and a pretty much vegetable and fruit fast. I remember, and I know people be like, well, why are you fasting? You're already little. You got to remember, it's not just about your weight. Because when you're bloated, you're gassy, then that means your gut is having some challenges. Or, if, you know, some people, they talk about, I have acid reflux. That means your system is very acidic. Oh my God. And so if that's the case, then your body is trying to say, So, and I realized when I started changing, like probiotics, people don't say probiotics. You need probiotics and prebiotics. Yeah. That's going to get the bacteria. Now, I promise you, I remember we had ate some pizza. Everybody in the house got sick because they were, it was bad food. I was taking probiotics. So I didn't have a stomach bug that everybody, I mean, I had a little run, but nothing like everybody in the house. They were like, just really sick. How it is when you have the stomach food poison. That's the word. And so that good bacteria, the prebiotics helps feed the good bacteria. The probiotics helps get rid of the bad. So you want to take those daily if you have gut issues. Like I said, do a detox at least once a month, and then fast. Fasting kind of cleanses the body, resets the body. Yeah. People don't like water, but water definitely lemon. Put some lemon in it. So, it's just small things. Some people like fast. I try to fast the first 3 days of the month or at least once a week, 12 hours. And one night I told my sister, I was fasting for 12 hours while doing the detox. And I felt, I'm little, but my stomach can poke out because it's not always cleansed. So I noticed I noticed the difference. So if you fast and take a detox and then come out of the fast eating fruits and vegetables, you're cleansing your body.
Yeah.
And just try to do that once a month because we put so much in there.
Yeah. Because I think a lot of times people fast and they think that's like a magical cure. You know what I'm saying? Like everything's going to be better. But the way what you just said was, fast. And then even once you're done with the fast, still eat fruits and vegetables.
Yeah,
because some people fast, then they go back to eating, burgers or, so you kind of defeated the purpose of doing the fast.
And give it like 3 days, once a week or something. If you're going to do once a week, I would suggest 12 hours at least. If you're going to do it 3 days, then maybe go like a 7 to 3, only water. Because some people like to do it only water, do a detox with it. And the good thing about this detox is you take like the pills at nighttime, and it's not that I got to be bad bathroom kind of detox. Not to be so vivid, but but you know how I mean when you take some of those detox, but you know it's working, but it's like you just go, but it's not more the one that's I can't do this because I'm working, because that'd be happy. People are like, I can't detox, I have to work. No, just make sure that you drink water, you use the bathroom in the morning, and you're good for the day, because it's typically done at bedtime.
Okay.
Wow.
And we suggest like 10-day detox.
A 10-day, okay. Yeah. Like, you're really knowledgeable on, so many levels of health. Are you offering, consultations, or is that something that you're looking to get into in the future?
So currently now I do offer consultations. So like you call and say, hey, I've been having a stomach issue, what should I do? So I do offer that. I also have, which I'm still working on, nutritional guides. One of them is a diabetic nutritional guide. One is heart disease, because most times people have diseases but they don't know how to deal with it naturally. So the guide is telling you what the disease is, how to deal with it from a natural standpoint. Even while on medicine, I would never tell you to come off your whatever the doctor is giving you. So I offer those. Those are not like ebook form. It's just more like if you talk to me, I'll send it to you from that standpoint. But I am going to have all of this eventually. But on the website, you are able to do memberships, seminars for those, sometimes churches may want you to come in and talk about health, or schools. And then the last thing I am working on in the future is a health course, like a 5-week course. Hitting those basics of how do I deal with such and such, and then once you hit that course, you'll have information. As long as you're a member, you'll be able to have that information throughout your health journey. So those are the things that's through Natural Stimulus that I am working on.
Yeah. Okay. Good. So you have a plan, already mapped out.
So that's the goal. And working on that children's. But I know it's going to be illustrative, so I don't want it to just be, because they'll look at words and say, what is this?
Right.
But that that illustrative book for children, because sometimes we don't really think, oh, I'm young, I can be healthy when I get older. We don't realize our health starts now.
Yeah.
I can't eat hot sauce without having heartburn.
Right.
Yeah.
And I highly dislike it, but
So what's some advice you would give someone that says, you know, eating healthy is too expensive?
Two things. True, it can be, because I get it. Mm-hmm. But also being sick is expensive. So, or just, and I mean, from there, like your doctor bills, you know, paying for your medicine, and just, you know, one thing, I don't like no kind of pain, no kind of discomfort. So when I had that GERD, and it was like my stomach felt like it was in knots, and like I had an ulcer, and I'm like, they couldn't figure out anything. I said, something's got to give. Now, I know people who they don't care. They go eat what they want to eat, and they'll be on the toilet, dine, have what they want to do. It's just like, I like food. So me, if some make me sick, I'm not, it's just me. But I would say this, it can be, but you also have to think about it. No one is saying that you have to change your whole lifestyle. Once you start introducing your body, just like water, it becomes something you crave. I do not crave things anymore because I'm used to it. So start, you know, salad. Yeah, it's about $2. You know, $3, and you can get a whole meal for $5 at Burger King. I get it, or $7 now with, you know, inflation. But you know, just start implementing, and eventually you'll realize it's not as expensive as you think. You know, and you may, people say, I get hungry. Well, snack, you know, there's more snacks, but I eat the same that everybody else. I just don't often add meat. You know, I don't fry my food. They have air fryers now. Bacon, you got Instapots now, so you can still do. I switch, instead of white rice, I do brown rice. It's a dollar, you know. Just taking some small steps, and then that's why I said too, if you're saying that eating healthy, like from the grocery store standpoint, then get your supplement so that you can at least start giving your body something. But eliminate, if you want to really just focus on, I would say eliminate the fried foods and the sugars. If you can eliminate sugar and that fried stuff, then you're starting your journey. I'm not gonna say you're halfway there. I'm not gonna say you're halfway there, but you're starting your journey. And I know it's so many things out there now that makes it a little easier. Honey, coconut, sugar, all this other stuff. So like I don't put white sugar in anything probably for about a year and a half or 2 years now.
That's so great.
Yeah, I'm trying to. I went to the doctor, and he was saying it too, like eliminate the sugar.
Yes.
I think my number was kind of, it wasn't over,
but it was borderline.
It was like, so he was just like, make sure you know, try to cut out the sugars as much as you can. I'm just like, oh God.
and if you're not, then you need to burn it through it. And then we see, the thing is, we eat bad, but then we don't want to exercise, and then we don't want to drink water. We still want to. And when I learned this, I think I was drinking. I was kind of mad at myself. I was coming back from out of town, and I was like, oh, let me get this sweet tea. It said no sugar. And it said cane sugar. Then I looked on the back, I'm like, 48 grams? And you start looking at it, you'd be like, 40. And so I am going to do something. You've seen those little posts where it shows you how much sugar is in each drink.
Yeah.
Just really showing people, and then showing, because you can show them that, but what does sugar really do? And I had 3 family members that went, unfortunately, passed away from cancer, and that's really what sparked it. And just the doctors were talking about, like, sugar feeds the cancer cells.
Wow.
And so we just don't realize, you know, that our, and what people are like, well, what is cancer in this? Cancer is just an abnormal cell that didn't die. It's a cell that didn't die. It became abnormal. And it can come in your body at any time, because our cells are always living and dying and replicating.
Yeah.
And so you just want to make sure. That's why it's so easy for me now, because I'm conscious of what the body does.
Right.
Like, okay. Yeah. If I do this consistently, I'm feeding this cell, and this cell, you know, and the best way I'll say it, cells makes tissues, tissues make organs, organs make systems. So each cell is building your system.
Yeah.
And I have an unpublished thing called the 5 leading causes of death. And one of them, you know, is cancer and heart disease. But it all stems from those cells that are unhealthy.
Right.
And we just keep eating and keep doing and keep. And then the next thing we know is hey, can everybody help me, when we already at that last stage?
Right.
So it's just choices. That's why the group is called Choosing Help, because it's definitely a choice.
Yeah. Mm.
Wow. I didn't know that. I really didn't know that. Like, you really just informed me on something. So, man, that's enough right there to really say I'm definitely going to change, because this cancer, it is nothing to play with at all.
And once you, you know, even diabetes, I know people who have that and just thinking about you on medicine forever, mm-hmm. or not forever unless you make a straight change. But it's like, you can reverse a disease. I don't want to say that. But reversing it takes a lot of work. So why not, you know, which is why my motto is choosing health to live beyond sickness and disease. Because mm-hmm. if I don't choose health, then disease or sickness is inevitable eventually at some point.
Yeah.
And when I saw this 80-year-old man, mm-hmm. when I used to do insurance, he did not have no, when I asked him, I said, what is your, what medicine you take? The only thing I use is eye drops. I said, got it. That opened my eyes.
Right.
Whereas there was another one who had a shoebox this size full of pills. Yeah. And we know that every pill got a side effect. It's one thing, and it's harming the neck. So,
it's good to really educate yourself on, you know, like you said, the body, the cells and everything like that, mm-hmm. and the food that you're taking in, how it really affects your body. Because mm-hmm. I don't think people are really health conscious. They're just, you know, they're hungry, they want to eat, mm-hmm. and they just pick mm-hmm. something up. Mm-hmm. But it's important to really know, you know, it really changes your mindset when you educate yourself on what these foods are doing to you. Because mm-hmm. like you said, Alicia, you know what it does to you. So it's more easier for you to be like, okay, I'm not choosing this hamburger, I'm choosing, you know, mm-hmm. something else. Right. So it makes it a lot easier to make those choices, you know, versus it being like more of a difficult choice. Right. It's not so much mm-hmm. difficult once you know what is causing, you know, in the long mm-hmm. run.
And then you have those two things I was gonna say. You have those people, because I remember I was talking to someone and they were like, well, we all go die from something. And I was like, well, not necessarily. So you do have those who don't really care. They're just like, I'm gonna eat what I want to eat. I just mm-hmm. would. But when you see people suffer, like I said, I had three family members that mm-hmm. I've seen experience, you know, like the watching it go from, and I don't know their health or their eating habits, but just watching them and I now knowing, because I had to study, I'm like, okay, what is cancer? What's going on? I remember I just sat down one day and really looked into it, and just watching that one changes your mind. And then me, I'm always a planner and figuring things out. So I'm always going to figure out cause and effect. What is this cause? If I do this, how am I affected? And because I'm that kind of person, it's one of those. I'm not a, if I see something do you wrong, I'm not the one that's gonna go that same path. Oh, that hurt you? Oh no, I'm good. So it's kind of your personality and your care. Some people are risk takers and they're like, I'm gonna live life, I'm gonna enjoy life. Mm-hmm. But I think if you want to live and enjoy life, I know of some people who are 80 years old, they're still driving and still going, but I know 80-year-olds who are sitting in a home and mm-hmm. can't go down the stairs, and mm-hmm. I don't want to live that way. So we have to live for our future, not for our now.
Wow.
Do you want to be on oxygen, or do you want to be able to say I'm 80 and I'm hopping on planes and on a roof or somewhere? Because I always hear my bones, my this, but I know some people who are really living life,
right?
In their elderly years.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah,
that makes me think.
Yeah, it does.
Mm-hmm.
It does.
Yes.
Yeah, and I just want to say that you are such a blessing to the people that you are educating and you're around, because if it wasn't for you, some of these people wouldn't know, you know, what's out there or how to prevent it. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So I think that's such a blessing that you want to educate other people and even do like the children's book, and you have the supplements. So I really think that's a blessing for, you know, people that you are impacting.
Yeah. Well, thank you. It's definitely my passion. I grew up saying I wanted to go in the medical field. Like, you know, we've all have some gift or calling that we feel inspired to. Yeah. And mine was, I was going to be a medical pediatrician. But, you know, after really going through my experience, I'm like, they just want to give you scripts. They're not listening, this and that. And it's just like, but one thing, when I learned about naturopathic medicine, which is natural medicine, it just like I took off and I just went there. And after having my own experience, but there's so many people who are sick. Because some days I'm like, well, do people really? But there are so many people who are unfortunately sick and just need help and just don't know. And just, you know, how can I change or whatever? And so that's my goal. It's not even about the products as more as it is about the education.
Because the education is the key.
Yeah, that definitely is the key.
But some people say, I don't want water, I don't drink water, I don't like, but then they don't realize what water is doing and what. And you've been in enough science classes, you'll know what the cells are. You know, even going back from biology. So and I dislike biology, frankly. But now it's like, okay, that's what them said. That's what they was talking about, them cells and those DNAs and ribosomes and all that.
So. Right.
Yes.
I was like, give me chemistry, but biology is very, very important.
Yeah. Yeah. So what are some misconceptions, I guess, people have about health or being healthy that you found or noticed?
Well, one, you know, we have talked about, oh, my family had this, my family died from this, and it's been said a lot too, but, you know, heart disease, diabetes, and all that is not necessarily a gene, a genetic disorder. Right. I know we often believe that, but what happens is, my mom grew up eating pork, I grew up eating pork, we grew up in that nature, so it's kind of like nurture versus nature, and so we keep on in the same bad habits, or we add other habits. You'll see like your family with alcoholics, okay? Everybody is drinking because that's what we're used to. And then, now one thing I did, I was doing some research on, and there's a familiar celebrity who does have a gene, a cancer gene. Now, I had to look, I'm like, is that really genetic? But they said because of something that with their genes, it is a genetic gene that causes, can lead to stomach cancer. But for the most part, most of your diseases come from your desire or your choice. So I remember when my sister first came home, was like, well, I'm not eating pork no more. We was like, girl, you crazy, blah, blah, you know. And then getting into health, we was like, so now it's just like it became a normal thing. And we start realizing that even if they said they're not raising foods the same way. So to a lot of high blood pressure and all of those things. So the big thing is don't think that, you know, you're destined. Well, I'm destined to have heart disease. You can make a choice to say, I know my family ate this way. I can choose to do differently. I don't have to have that disease. That's one of the things, because we get caught up in, I gotta have this disease because my family. So that is a myth. You can reverse the curse and reverse those genetic things that has taken your family out. And then, like you said, going back to the focus of health is expensive. You have to just look at it as, you know, once a week, go to the grocery store, go to the produce aisle first. And then, you know, get you some color. Make sure your cart is full of colors, red, orange, green, yellow. Do that once a week. You're getting that in once a week. We're definitely not hitting the mark with the three times a day. Most people are not, unless you're eating raw. So just try to focus on that. It's just like, I don't have to just only eat vegetables, but just adding in a vegetable or fruit every meal is definitely. And that also another thing people don't realize is when you're thirsty, your body is dehydrated. So we shouldn't be being thirsty. We should not be thirsty. So your body, you should be getting enough liquids in where your body doesn't have to say drink. So when your body is saying I'm thirsty, that means that in a sense your cells are dehydrated. So that's another fact that people don't understand, like, why am I so thirsty? Because your body is saying your cells need. But if you're getting your 64 ounces or half your body weight, 1 gallon in a day, I know it's difficult. People are saying, well, why do I have to use the bathroom? You're cleansing, you're purifying, you're detoxifying your system. So those are just a few things that I've noticed, and that you know, food is definitely medicine. The body can heal itself. And yeah. so no matter what the doctor is saying, I've seen and I've even heard of how things have changed. And health is definitely a mindset. So it's not just about physical health. It's about emotional health as well as spiritual health.
Right.
You need something higher than you to, as I often say, to really, you know, drive home. Like, because there's going to be days you ain't going to make it. You're going to have affirmations. Even the book, it has affirmations in there, prayers in there. So something that's greater than you. Health is a choice. And not every day I feel like getting up and doing any of this. And, you know, hey, is it making a difference? Or, you know, so I have to have something greater than me that's going to say I can do all things.
So that's
the biggest thing. It's just knowing that health is a choice.
Yeah.
It's like you choose to put on clothes and choose your outfit.
Right, right.
And want to be cute, you know. I don't even do eyelashes, but I chose to put them on today. So, you know, I just like I chose to do that. I have to choose to this morning eat some fruit and not, you know, coffee is something is a treat for me because I shouldn't drink it for the it makes me acidic. But some days I choose and say, you know what? I deal with the acid because I need the coffee.
You got to
make choices. So.
It's an investment.
Yes.
Like a long-term investment. Mm-hmm. You know, when you eating healthy, you know, as soon as you start eating healthy, your body is changing for the better. So I look at it as a long-term investment for sure.
Yep, and that's why I started with the one day, because if you tell people, oh, try to be healthy for a year, if you're looking at that long term. But if you just say one day at a time.
Yeah, definitely.
One day at a time. So, Sheeta, you just got to say, okay, what am I going to do today? If it's just drink, that's in the book. If it's just a drink, 2 cups of water, you set a goal. Okay, what am I going to do tomorrow? Right. I'm going to eat an apple. Okay, I ate an apple.
Yeah.
You know, if it's the next day, I'm going to pray for my health. Okay. Whatever it is, just, it don't have to even be just food, just every day make a health goal.
Yeah. Right. Realistic things that you can do. So,
yeah. And I like that the book is individualized. So, you know, you're not just putting each person in that same box. Each person has different goals.
Yes.
Things that each person wants to work on, you know, it might be different from the next. So this book is really individualized to where it can be for anybody, no matter what their goals are.
And you get to write it. And so like day one, it tells you the topic is why, gives you that information. And then you write, like you said, individually. So it's your own journal.
Yeah.
So I'll be putting a flyer out, hopefully in the next day or two, because in April, try to get all those summer people who want to get their health in order. We're going to take the journey in April for anyone who wants to join that 30-day health, whatever it is that you want to do. Taking you by the hand, because sometimes it's just I need someone to take me by the hand. I had to do it by myself. I tell my family all the time, I'm like, y'all don't be going with me. I'm like, come on. So I try not to be the food police, but sometimes it's like, how much sugar did you use today? And that just seems like pour salt and my eyes goes like this, or sugar, and I'd be like, you know. I'd be like, oh my gosh. And it's like people don't, then they'd be like, yeah, my leg hurt today. Yeah, it was all that salt you just put on your food.
Yeah. So. Wow. Thank you so much for coming on. You want to let everybody know how they can get in touch with you, how they can get the book, all that good stuff.
So my page, Natural Stimulus, and Stimulus is spelled with an E, focusing on STEM from the plant. So we want to focus on the natural things that stimulate our body. So naturalstimulus.com, the book is on there. And like I said, if you want to be a part of that 30-day health journey, then I encourage you to get the book. And so you can order the book on there. You can also, any services or products is also on the naturalstimuluspage.com. I do have a Facebook page, Natural Stimulus, a Facebook page and a group, which is a smaller portion for people. Just sometimes I post in there, send some engagement and just, you know, helping people on their journey and just like a smaller group. So those are the ways that you can contact me. And then the page does have like where you can text or message or email. And like I said, if you are looking to subscribe or get your monthly vitamins, you can do that as well online.
Yeah.
Yes. I love it.
Yes. Thank you so much, Alicia, for joining us today and really educating our listeners on, you know, choosing health, you know. And we really appreciate you taking the time out to join us today.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you for having me and just allowing me to come and share my gift and what God has chosen me to do. Everybody has theirs. Definitely Real Conversation is awesome. Just allowing people to really, you know what's going on and just conversate. Sometimes we just need to conversate. So I'm grateful to be able to conversate with you both and believe that this is a time now that we choose health so that we can live beyond sickness and disease.
Yes, I love it.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
And take care.
So we want to thank Miss Alicia Mosley for coming on the show today. Hopefully she can help you guys out with any health tips and advice that you may need. We look forward to speaking with her again when her next book comes out.
Yes.
And today's takeaway is you are the artist of your own life. Don't hand the paintbrush to anyone else.
Okay, I like that.
Live your own dream. As we always said, be your real, true, authentic self. You know, a lot of things that you see out here on social media, TV, is not realistic.
No, it's not.
Live your own dream.
Yeah, set your own rules, your own boundaries. You know, you don't have to be like anyone else. Be your own self. And when you be your own self, that's when you really shine.
Yes.
So, I say do you, boo.
Okay. Yes.
But yes, so make sure you all follow Alicia on her Facebook page and her website, y'all. And then make sure you all subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Real Conversations with Sheeta and Nikki Podcast. Catch up on all the latest episodes on our YouTube channel. And also, when you subscribe to our channel, you get access to podcast episodes 2 days sooner than on other podcast platforms. You will also have the opportunity to view bonus content and videos, okay? Also, follow us on TikTok, which is Sheeta and Nikki.
Yes.
And also, follow us on our Instagram page, which is at RealConversations21. And if you would want to be a featured guest on our upcoming episode, please make sure you email us or contact us on Instagram at RealConversations21 or RealConversations21@gmail.com. We would love to have you.
Yes. Thanks so much for watching.
Peace.